Here, I'm inviting our college IQAC coordinator, Dr. Manu Chadha, for deliberating on the objective and the theme of the webinar. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Raman. Dr. Pargat, sir, can we start?
Yes, please. Okay. Please go ahead, ma'am.
Okay. Very warm good afternoon to the August audience. Hope and wish you all are safe and healthy during the third wave of COVID-19. Making the best out of this pandemic, we have all gathered to deliberate on a much challenged and imperative issue of the times, innovations and intellectual property rights. Just a brief background that about the, as you all know, you must have seen on the brochure that this webinar we are holding this webinar in collaboration with the Mentee colleges. Our college was accredited grade A in the second cycle of NAC by NAC and was granted the mentor status by UGC under the Paramar scheme. We were assigned the job to mentor at least 5 institutions for NAC accreditation. So today, in collaboration with these Mentee colleges, that is Arya College, Ludhiana, Atam Vallabh Jain College, Ludhiana, Cordia College, Sangol, Innocent Hearts College, Jalandhar, and Park Singh Memorial Girls College, Sukhanand Moga, we've tried to make a small effort on a very important theme, which I personally feel is highly important on and on which we educators are minimally aware. Friends, universities, and public research institutions are among the direct contributors towards innovation and research, particularly in emerging economies. The potential pool of talent for innovation in these economies always emanates largely from educational institutions and research institutions. Of late, the significance of IPR in higher education has widely been recognized. This could probably be due to the credited to the national IPR policy that has been approved by the Union government in 2016. And in fact, it is the first ever IPR policy framed by the government of India. The primary focus of this policy is to promote innovation and creativity, especially among the entrepreneurs in the higher education institutions. The policy specifically mentions synergizing all forms of IPR and tapping the creativity and innovative energies of India with emphasis on startups and educational institutions. The UGC, which is a nodal authority for higher education, has issued a letter for making this as a generic elective subject under the CBCS scheme. In addition, we are all aware of NIRF, the ranking system that is adopted by MHRD. Then the NAC accreditation, the criterion 3 of NAC, that is research, innovation, and extension. All these formats include promoting innovation, research, and development while assessing beyond the academics. So this all includes IPR and patents, both published and granted by the students as well as the faculty members. And this has been given due weightage over the times in the years. The publications and patent applications, in fact, if we see the background, we see that it has been the highest amount in the since this policy came into being. This policy basically came into being in 2016. And if we see that there is now a rising trend towards IPR, towards publications, towards patenting. But still I feel that the awareness of IPR is limited to higher education institutions. Basic reason may be that what I feel that this needs to be a part of a curriculum in the schooling, because the actual ingraining of the awareness, it starts at an early stage. Then I don't know, plenty of you must have read this. There is a very good study which has been done on basically school students, teachers, managers of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, and Telangana. It was a study on intellectual property, rights, needs, and awareness. And that approximately there were 200 respondents, and the results showed that there was minimal awareness about the monetary benefits of acquiring an IP right. Most of them were not aware about the benefits of IP and other related issues, the commercialization of acquired IP rights, and above all, the legal troubles that one might face if we use a pirated product. We just know that we cannot use a pirated CD or a pirated video. More than that, we are not aware of it. So this was there. Another thing that was noted in that study was that nearly 35% respondents were still not aware about IPRs, though they all belong to the intellectual class. I've already told you they were students, school scholars, teachers, and managers. Then only real understanding was there only with 5%. And that 5%, what I could gather was maybe from the law background, because what it's only in the law, and especially commercial law, that this IPR is a subject. Otherwise, we've not seen it as a subject in any of the courses. So respondents pointed, in fact, above all, 70% of the respondents did not even know that they have an IP department in their college, and whether the college was registering for IP or something like that. So this study basically recommends that to fulfill the need of spreading awareness about IPRs, the budding professionals, entrepreneurs, and all the other stakeholders need more information, orientation, and facilities for protecting their intellectual powers. After going through this study, I felt we are all sailing in the same boat. And sure, so the new scenario has come to impact on the curricular content of IP teaching programs. Thus, I feel there is a dire need to seek observations focusing on how education and training in IP can be improved in an attempt to make it more instrumental and conducive in the promotion of innovations. So today, we at GIG Khalsa College of Education, in collaboration with our mentee colleges, are trying to gain an insight on this much demanded topic of the day, though through a man of repute and expertise, Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda, Dean, Research and Development Cell, Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology, Orissa. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation. And also that also at a very short notice. We will be looking forward for a lot of information from you, because as already quoted, we are minimally aware about this topic. So before handing over to you, I would request our principal, Dr. Pargat Singh Garcha, to formally welcome the revered resource person and the impressive audience. Over to Dr. Pargat Singh Garcha, please.
Thank you, Dr. Manu. A very good afternoon to all present in this webinar through this UMAP. I, on behalf of the College Management Committee, Faculty of GIG Khalsa College of Education, Gursar Sudhar, extend a heartiest welcome to our resource person of today's webinar, Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda, and respected principals of our 5 mentee colleges under UGC Paramarsh scheme, and the learned faculty members who have joined us in this special webinar on innovations and IPR practices. I would like to share with all the participants that our college is serving the society from more than 7 decades. Our college is making continuous efforts to contribute in the field of teacher education. Our efforts are recognized by NAC 2 times by awarding us A grade. So due to this A grade, we are working as a mentor in UGC Paramarsh scheme. We are telling our experiences to our 5 mentee colleges and learning so many things from those 5 mentee colleges, which can improve the work culture among the mentor and the mentee colleges, infrastructure, faculty, and students. Friends, we know that innovation and technology development have been recognized for their central importance for economic success and growth, at least since the 1930s. Intellectual property right, such as patent, trade, secret right, and copyrights have been caught increasing attention during the last 2 decades. So this webinar was planned to get some useful inputs in the above areas for our faculty members in our college as well as the five mentee colleges. So during the next 1.5 hours, we will try to learn the nuances of the innovations and IPR practices from an experienced person who has already filed a number of patents in different agencies. No doubt we know that this field basically belongs to the law people, the science people, and the social sciences. In the field of social sciences, there is very small work. We will also request her to correlate to some extent with the social sciences so that we who are dealing with the social sciences can also try our hands in innovations and IPR practices. So with these words, once again, I welcome Professor Ramesh Chandra Pandaji for this webinar. Now I request Dr. Ramandeep for the further proceedings, please.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon to all. Now, dear participants, it is the time to introduce our esteemed resource person of the day, Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda, Dean, Research and Development Cell, Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology, Odisha. Our esteemed guest is an educationist with distinguished professional career. Sir has a vast academic and industrial experience of 14 years, wherein he has provided educational instructions and training solutions to the students. He has also engineered many projects. Sir is editor and reviewer of 6 international UGC CLEAR-listed and Scopus indexed journals. Sir has authored and edited 12 textbooks, to name a few: Industrial People Management and Joy of Engineering and Management. Professor Ramesh has published 28 research papers and published 78 research patents and research copyrights under Intellectual Property Rights of India and indexed at WIPO Switzerland. Professor Ramesh has been granted 6 Australian patents and filed more than 15 Australian innovation patents. Dr. Panda is a self-directed, enthusiastic educator with a passionate commitment to institute development and learning experience. Sir has always undertaken challenging, enriching, and innovative activities catering to the diverse interests and needs of the students. Now, without taking much time, I would like to invite our resource person, Professor Panda, to start with his deliberation. Over to you, sir.
I'm audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Namaskar to everyone. First of all, I am very thankful to our principal, sir, and madam for giving me this opportunity. Actually, today I'm on the way to one temple here in New Delhi. So I found one friend's house so that at least I can deliver the webinar very peacefully. As sir told that in respect to social science, that very least innovations are available. Let me tell you first, every innovations are primarily meant for social perspectives, whether it's engineering, whether it's a management, whether it's education, whether it's law, right? Our foremost objective as agenda before filing of patents, through the claims, through the novelty checkups, through the prior art of developments, in every perspective, our first and foremost objective supposed to be how this innovation can helpful for the society. So irrespective of all the disciplines, all the departments, innovation is made for only societal importance and societal applications, right? Thank you. So let me tell you first, these days I'm working with KIMS Medical College here by Bhubaneswar, pediatrics department with Dr. Santosh Kumar Panda. We are coming with some utility innovations for newborn babies and premature delivers, right? let me showcase a few of my innovation is called cost effective thermal matrices to avoid neonatal hypothermia. It's one of the potential innovation, and where primarily challenge how it can come to market. Second innovation right now I'm working together. It's a novel compact device for newborn or premature jaundice treatment. This is the second innovation. I already worked and filed the patents. We are coming with one light therapy, few sustainable approaches, right? Yes, yes. Please come to the previous slide, please. Yes, 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 yes. Previous one.
Is it okay, sir?
Yes, okay, sir. Next one. Okay, fine. So through this pandemic, what we learn exactly that all of our intellectual society, starting from the students, faculties, innovators, incubators, startups, companies, right? All are put at their effort best to learn and to implement their theorems and fundamental into realistic product development that can helpful for the society through this pandemic. You can find few of the potential innovations considering your cost effective ventilators. I'll let you know few of innovation happened with under guidance of my team, team professors and faculty members. We associated with few, you know, student mentees here for final year mechanical and electrical department. PPEs, low cost PPEs, then transportation system, remote health monitoring system. Like this, people are invested their best. Whatever they are learning from the textbook even, they are comprised, means accumulating all the fundamental together and bringing new solution for the society, right? Let me showcase few of my innovations. Sustainable solar assisted all natural clay cool refrigeration system, IoT based sustainable manufacturing of organic fertilizers. I developed this project into two different forms. Number one, windmill operated and solar assisted. My third innovation is air or water. It's a temperature dependent extraction of drinking water from your atmosphere. One of my potential innovation and filed under intellectual property right government of India, that is called 5G based optimized controlled humanoid robot with IoT based handheld ECG machine effective for intensive care units, wind powered IoT based sustainable organic compost machines, formulation and preparation of alcohol free herbal sanitizers, e-vidyale, it's a portal. In this way, we can take education and social science students together for the innovation approaches. It's an approach we developed and through mobile integrations, which will be helpful for the faculty and students together for better learning process. You can say it's a better web portal or feature having different multiple features compared to your Zoom and Google Meet. Smart carbonless cooking gasifier. It's incredible innovations which avoid bronchitis of underdeveloped areas, women. IoT-based cost-effective, smart, sustainable water pumper, and adopting and researching different type of innovative treatment approaches for hospital wastewater and detecting COVID infections. Apart from this innovation, I put my effort best into sustainable approaches into water sanitations, number one. Healthcare unit, I put more effort into newborn baby and a new premature deliver care devices. And nowadays I'm working with deep learning. It's a technology for identification and easy recognition of different type of symptoms, skin diseases, of premature delivers or newborn babies under guidance of Dr. Santosh Panda, KIMS Medical College, Bhuvaneshwar, SCB Medical College, Cuttack, and a few physicians nearby our Bhuvaneshwar and Cuttack hospital faculties. Next slide, please. Right. Next. Next. Yes. Before 3 months, I visited KIMS Medical College. Actually, neonatology or pediatrics is the, you know, you can say it's a best, it's a field where you can put your effort best for best resource practices for young mothers, premature deliver and newborn babies, right? On the left side, you can see one instrument. On the right side, you can say, you can see another device. You can see, you can, you know, declare it's a device. It's a potential incubators for newborn babies. Actually, what happens when baby inside mother womb, right? The body temperature supposed to maintain 36.5 degrees centigrade to 37.5 degrees centigrade. And the core temperature supposed to maintain exactly 28 degrees centigrade. But when baby comes outside, our surrounding temperature is different. Sometime it's in between 20 degrees, sometime 30, sometime 40, sometime 45, sometime 50. So newborn baby not able to adapt or, you know, correlate the internal and external temperature in a right propagative way. That leads to hypothermia. Research said more than 21% of newborn baby dies in urban and semi-urban areas only due to the hypothermia defects, which may leads the baby into side paralysis or baby may go for the coma. And the practices available in ICU very expensive. This open heart system you can see on the left side, the machine cost itself 15 lakh rupees. A right side machine is not less than 28 lakhs. Now you think about it, per day expenses coming not less than 12 to 15,000 rupees. If a person is earning 20,000 rupees per month, how he can afford this costly, you know, machineries or facility for ICUs? So with this contest, we developed one innovation that is called cost-effective thermal matrices to avoid hypothermia for neonatal patients. So what we did exactly, next slide please. Yes, we have taken one automatic temperature control sensor, 0.5 gauge copper wires with some insulating covering, 2 layer of thermal matrices, and some electronic connections. Next slide, please. Yes, you can see here, we have taken two modes of operation. First mode of operation in between 34 to 36.5, it's a transportable device. After, you know, delivery, baby delivery, you can put the baby inside, right? And you can take to your house or to hospital approaches, you can consider this device. And total cost engaged with the for development of this innovation is 600 rupees. And having the better feasibility to maintain the required temperature in between 36.5 degrees centigrade to 37.5 degrees centigrade. Every innovation required validation, resource validation. So with my student team of final year mechanical department, we visited two more hospitals. One government hospital nearby, SCB Medical College, and KIMS Medical College with a team of doctors. We validated this project, and now this project is successfully filed patent under Australian government, and we received the patent grants. Patent is a profitable job. Let me tell you, three key points of patent. There is a registration fees of $180 under if you are going for, you know, Australian patents. Attorney fees is there. The attorney is supposed to be a permanent residential or green card holder of Australia. Number two, before developing an innovation, you have to study the prior art of reports. Where exactly you have taken the problem statement. The best practice of education fulfilled when, as an educationalist or, you know, faculties or mentees, we do understand the real-time problem statement faced by the society and how we are integrating our knowledge, theorems, techniques, technologies, wisdoms, fundamentals together to develop such kind of innovation that will be helpful for the society. Getting PhD degree, getting certificate is not fulfilling the moral ethics of higher education. Higher education will fulfill when we'll do understand the real-time problem statement. You can understand throughout this COVID time how you suffered. Education was a bandwidth for us. Hospital facility was not available properly. Remote education not properly maintained. Student children's, they deprived of tuition, schools, colleges. And you can see on the other hands, how students, faculties, one student developed one ventilator in 250 rupees from your lovely professional university. One of my students developed one transportation patient carrier within 3,000 something, 350, 3,500 rupees something using some automated guided vehicle mechanisms and full controlled isolation sample. Right? So these are the aspects we have to take care of. Before doing any innovation, we have to study the problem statement. We have to formulate our design properly. We need to simulate our design properly. We have to discuss about its theorem, how it is working. Through a well-demonstrated diagram, we have to describe it very properly. And what is the newness? What is the novelty of your innovation? That we have to understand, and we have to narrate properly through our drafting patterns before filing, right? Claims. What sort of technology you are integrating? What sort of benefits? And how this innovation exactly helpful with respect to its agenda and outcomes, that's supposed to be a prime part of a patent drafting. Next. Cost-effective water filtration using industrial fly ash waste is the minor project submission by under-guided mechanical department students. Nowadays, you can find DST, METI, Technology Development Board, Government of India, MSME Government of India, all are putting effort best into sustainable water filtrations and cleaning means how we can get cleaned water, clean drinking water, right? So with this approach, we motivated our student best for this innovation. So what we did exactly, we primarily focused on industrial waste. And fly ash is considered as a best consumable electrical industrial waste. We have taken 60% by weight of your fly ash. We added binders. In this case, we have considered bentonite as a prime binder element. We have taken 15 to 20% by weight of your bentonite and added water. We mixed it and put it inside a mold. On the third figure, you can see we kept the mold inside a furnace, ranging temperature in between 600 degrees centigrade to 650 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. And I'm holding the cartridge on the right side with sufficient porosity for filtration purpose. And total cost involved to generate one water filter cartridge is 10 rupees. That is indicates the cost effective approach of innovation. The best part of research is when you can reduce the cost, consumable item reduce, when you can reduce the cost of a product. That is the best approach, not to write research papers or not to publish into, you know, some index journals. Maybe it's a nowadays means to fulfill the requirement of UGC, AICT, NAC accreditations, NBA, ISO audits, right? We guys are putting efforts into publications. But when we can implement this theorems into some utility product innovation, innovation is the highest form. If you consider, you can, if you see the slope, starting from a, you know, beginner to a means a resourceful innovator or incubator or product developer, you can find innovation is the highest part of research. When you'll be mature enough to understand the problem statement, how, and how you can integrate all the resources together, all the fundamentals together with available resources, you can develop one such kind of utility product that will be helpful for the society. You can consider, you can compare the cartridge available in market. market. Your Tata, Aqualine, Aquafina, they're using nanotechnology. Nano is bad for health. I'm telling you. Girls are using that cream, that is Pond's cream. Within 5 minutes, you can bring fairness and glow in your face. Stop using that. Use that for 10 days, you can find the difference. You can find some dark spot in your face. That's why we're always putting our effort best for the sustainable practices, natural practices. That's why we're telling natural beauty is good, right? So with that context, if you compare the available categories price, not less than 2,000 to 3,000 rupees in market, right? And these practices using geolite or industrial fly ash based your water catteries, water filtration method, right? It's very cost effective and approachable even. I found before 2-3 days, one post over internet that here your IIC chamber with joint integration with IIT Bhubaneswar and SRM Engineering College, they're using geolite. Geolite as a water filter means water catteries, right? Next. Sustainable manufacturing process of eco-friendly 3D printing filament. Now government putting effort based, IIC putting effort based, AICT putting effort based. How our students, maybe it's a technical or non-technical student, maybe from education, social science, how student can learn destructive technologies like your 3D printing, machine learning, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, right? So I'm an expert, I'm having expertise with 3D printing, 3D plastic printing and 3D metal printing. So far, whatever observation I received from different published paper and a review paper and some innovative papers, no more company developed biodegradable time-dependent 3D filament. What exactly we are doing in 3D printing? Suppose you want to manufacture, my camera is visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, your camera is visible.
I'm not able to see, that's okay. It's visible. Can you see this bottle?
Sir, now it is not visible. Earlier it was showing your video.
Okay, sir, 1 minute.
Yes, now it's fine.
Now visible, sir?
It is visible.
Yes, sir. Yes, it is visible.
Okay. For example, I want to manufacture this doll, right? Okay. So what I have to do first, using any kind of design software, I need to design it. Maybe it's a SolidWorks, maybe it's a CATIA, maybe your AutoCAD, whatever, right? It's irrespective of all disciplines, all education society supposed to learn this destructive technologies, and we supposed to motivate student through different type of student clubs and in-house activities. We supposed to motivate them. We need to design it. Then we have to transform into SLA format. Then machine will be there, right? We need to send that information to the machine and machine will print it. If suppose you want like me, I can print using one, 3D scanner, I can scan my face, my head in 12 different degrees. Then I can assemble into a single piece, right? Then I can print it. If it is big size means I need to slice into different parts. Again, I can rejoin it. Otherwise, if it is small part means, at a single try or single printing, I can manufacture it. So far, filaments are available. This is non-biodegradable. Means with respect to time, it is not decaying. So we formulated one, what is that called? Your prominent method, or with my student, we designed one methodology, which form really biodegradable type of sea-based plant filament for the 3D printing machine using hydrolysis and polylactic acid fermentation methods. We have taken seaweed. CUET is a C plan, right? You can see starting from diagram 1 to 10, we have considered different processes, and we have not actually incubated this product. But yes, if you can, if you incubate, means definitely we'll successful through the means to manufacture biodegradable 3D printing product. We filed this patent under IP Australia. Let me tell you why in these days I'm putting efforts into international patent. Earlier I filed more than 50 number of Indian patents, not less than 20 number of Indian research copyrights, 18 number of industrial design patents, 15 number of your Australian innovation patents. Indian process bit slow actually. It's a long time recurring process. To grant an Indian innovation patent, it's not called innovation. It is called utility patent. It takes minimum 3.5 years time. It takes minimum 2.5 months time for only publication to reflect your name, designation, and submitted paper over IP India website. Then you have to wait for 8 months long period of time to generate the first examination report, right? Sir is connected with me in Facebook. Keep on sharing my examination report also. I'm sharing in my Facebook. I'm very Facebook addicted person, right? Then we need to submit it. Again, it will take for evaluation for 8 months, 8 or 9 months. So total complete procedure, it will take minimum 3.5 years time up to patent grant. US patent, UK patent, Australian patent, Korean patent, Japanese patent, and your European patent, they take minimum 3 to 2 years. Three months you can generate the grant certificate. People are spreading the rumors that there is no examination, not like that. Because we are filing the patent, we know how difficulties we are facing during the patent examinations. It takes 27 working days, only working day. At the first examination report, you can arrange the acceptance letter within 2 months of filing of your patent. 3 months time generally they used to take to, you know, arrange the grants for you. And after 5 days, you can download all the patent application form and draftings, including your declaration from your attorney and applicant and inventors. For Indian patent, as per government norms, IIC cell declared through MSME Government of India, there is a reimbursement of 1 lakh rupees for Indian patent grant. Even if you are applying for a patent, within 12 months, you can apply for patent reimbursement, whatever cost you are, you know, engaging to file a patent, or transportation, arranging resources, resource material, or resource validation, you may claim to a nearby MSME for 1 lakh rupees patent reimbursement cost. For international patent, there is a scheme of reimbursement up to 5 lakh rupees. If suppose you are filing under Australian IP or US IP or UK IP, reimbursement scheme allow you to reimburse up to 5 lakh rupees through MSME Government of India IIC coordinators. Right? Next. Digital iron removal filter for bore wells. I'm working here at Dhinkanal. It's a hilly mountainous area. Right? My college is surrounded by 7 mountains. And as you know, mountainous area, water means generally we are using bore wells to lift water. It's, you know, rich in iron percentage. So you can find, I can find a student having yellows and whitish, what is that called, marks on their teeth. And it's producing a lot of, you know, damages also to our body. So we developed one indigenous approach using 2 different types of digital display and 4 layers of sustainable practices, different grades of your grains, different grades of your sand particles, some gravels, some organic sustainable layers. And we filed the innovation patent at Taiwan, right? On the next slide, you can see the design. Next slide, please. 4 layers are there. Digital display, 2 digital displays are there to understand the percentage of you know, iron content in drinkable water at the inlet and outlet. I filed one Indian resource copyright also. Next. Self-guided vehicles for your e-vehicle. One concept is there. No? It's machine learning based automated guided self-sustainable hybrid e-vehicle. Right. It's an interesting matter actually. Nowadays, 30% of metro civilizations, young engineering student, young budding minds, they are very attracted towards, electric vehicles. But electric vehicle also requires some main source of power to charge up your battery, right? So we try to bring one a new self-directed and recycling type of approach into this hybrid e-vehicle. It's not like only they will get charged by your solar panel, not like that. Actually, we put two more battery in electrical vehicle. The best part of this innovation is we aligned or integrate DC generator as a prime moving part of your front axle of e-vehicle. DC generator, I think you all are aware about it. Generator is made up of two parts. One is central rotating part, and one is outer casing, right? When rotor will rotate, there will be engagement of flux exchanges or EMF electromotive force that will generate electricity, right? So what I did exactly through this approach and under guidance of few IIT and NIT faculties, before filing any patent, I used to discuss with all my mentors, all my professors, rich technological inventors. Then only you can validate the innovations. Yesterday, I found one person filed one patent named IoT approaches into agriculture. When you are filing a patent, you are supposed to very clear what is the objective and how it will be helpful for the society. In broad sense, if you file a patent means there will be less chance of patent grant. You're supposed to be very specific. Where you are putting your effort best, where you are engaging your intellect, and what's supposed to be the outcome. Very properly, you need to define the specification of integrated equipment or devices you are using for the innovation, number one. Number two, after development of the innovation, how it will be different from others' existing innovations. If you're coming with 0.1% positive or productive outcomes, that leads to patent grant. So what exactly we did? We have considered that DC generator is the integral part of your front axle of your e-vehicle. Two batteries are there. One battery will run the vehicle, and when the vehicle will run, same time power will generate from the front axle. It will store in secondary battery. There is a concept that total energy of the system is constant, right? That means input equal to output. Otherwise, you can say input equal to output plus pluses, different type of pluses, because all are using vehicles, some maybe cycle, maybe your motorcycle, scooty or car, right? That is called your conservation of energy. But through this experiment, we validated this innovation at our electrical lab. We reduced the torque. We are having a motor of 1,500 RPM. But the calculated RPM we found from the derivation, it's 230, right? So using some, a speed reducer, slow down the motor. And with the required torque, we calculated the total energy generator is more than the input given to the machine. Conservation of energy said that energy is constant, but we found that when you are integrating some extra inclusions with the innovations, the total outcome of the innovation is not less than 1.25% of potential energy given to the machine. Here I am violating this rule. I'm not be a, you know, big scientist or engineer or something, but our the formulations, program formulations and derivation formulated, exactly the output we received exactly, it is 1.25% more than the input given to the machine. And I think it will be a successful idea if suppose I will find any company or any, I'm searching for that. Ideology, ideation is not sufficient to file a patent. As I said, validation also required, sufficient experimentation also required. The best part of innovation when you are getting right approach or opportunity to develop it and bring to the society. That is the best part of innovation. Next slide, please. The design made by my students for electrical vehicle. Next. Self-cleaning and germ cleaning revolving public toilet for COVID-19. I filed one Indian resource copyright. I granted it. I filed one Australian innovation patent. I granted it. Next. Sustainable greenhouse for crops and drying of herbal medicinal plant. I filed one innovation patent. I granted it before 10 days. We filed one copyright for your cost-effective water filtration made by my student. We filed it and granted it. Arogya Odisha. It's one of my potential innovation throughout the COVID vacations. I'm a good learner. And I always motivate my student and faculty friends that learning is the best part of our life. The day we'll stop learning, we'll finish ourselves. Student will stop responding and respecting us. Throughout this COVID time, I learned the best practices into metal printing. I learned Python. I'm a mechanical guy with expertise of robotics and automation. I learned your machine learning, complete package of machine learning. 3D printing, 3D metal printing, I learned totally. And I learned how to develop mobile apps and website. It's not part of my curriculum or my expertise, but always we supposed to keep learning. Arogya Odisha is a portal which is empowering health monitoring and health consulting for urban and semi-urban peoples. I collected few social activist doctors. Actually, I belong to a doctor family, right? So through my father and my elder brother, I collected set of doctors group, some PG students of SCB Medical College and nearby MKCC Medical College. We gathered them, we arranged one meeting that how our education can helpful for the peoples. Because Odisha having, you know, underprivileged peoples are there. KBK, Koraput, Kalahandi, Balangir, right? Very poor people and jungle type peoples are there. Those are deprived of educations. They are not even maintaining themselves. If you search over internet, you can find the clear pictures of Kebika area of Odisha, right? So at a single click, you can download the health prescriptions, number one. If any kind of diagnosis required with respect to digit form, you can download it. And Sarkar Aapke Dwar, sorry, Hospital Aapke Dwar. This concept I narrated with this innovation through the, you know, mobile video conferencing. You can consult with your doctor. You can take the appointment. And it's a prime motivations for all the doctor community and patient together. Nowadays, I'm promoting this innovation with your KL University and how this product can, you know, come to real practice so that people can take benefits of it. I filed a patent. It's not suitable for patent, but after due consulting with my attorney, patent having two parts. First is take inside. Second one is attorney. Take inside means what sort of technology approaches or fundamental you are considering to bring a innovation. Attorney only to file the patent. There is no other role of attorney. They're developing the novel and prior art only. What sort of claims you are defining for your innovation? They're supposed to, you know, only fulfill the forms and submit the money, generate the money receipt of your drafts, whatever you're submitting for the filing of your patents. Next. is the copyright for the same. We granted it. It's the application form. Like this, you can see when you are applying for any kind of Indian research copyright, you can find all the detail by putting your registration number or name of applicant. You can find the details from the website, right? With your name, designation, university address, and PIN code, we suppose to apply. Robotic automated descent carrier for operation theater. One of university professors from Punjab, I forgotten their name. One that is university name. Anyway, he filed this patent for industrial design patents and Indian resource copyrights. Next slide, so that I can explain you. Yes, I visited SCB Medical College. Before filing any patent or bringing an innovation, I used to go for the case studies. I visualized the innovation, right? The picture of SCB Medical College, here you can find one nurse is operating one automatic kind of stretcher for operation theater. I asked them what is the, I have means gone through the brochure and manuals of this innovation. I found the product cost is not less than 7 lakh rupees. It's very pathetic actually. Here you, nowadays you can find monopoly of medical instrument and devices into healthcare industries because people are not aware about it. Number one, as people are very concerned to their health and family relative health, they never indulge into such kind of matter. Only where means we'll see how much cost, how much medical medicine cost, we pay for that. How much ICU cost, we'll pay for that. But we never visualize means what sort of facility with what technology they are, you know, using to develop the, this innovation. On the same contest, this is only one, you know, foldable type. There is no other technology integrated. Simple type of your stretcher used for the operation theater, right? With a backrest, right? I calculated, if suppose we'll engage our technologies together, we can bring this innovation within 50,000 rupees. You never believe. The kind of ventilators, the kind of, you know, ICU practices, ventilator, if you talk about ventilator, right? The minimum cost of ventilator is 2.5 lakh rupees. During this COVID, Ashok Leland, the company, they manufactured one ventilator with full place, all automatic kind of facilities or prominent features within 35,000 rupees. Now just, now you can imagine, means even if you can compare. During this COVID, the monopoly of healthcare industry destroyed completely. If you can see my you know, previous slide, you can find I attached one digital display there, which is integrated with a different type of sensor, 12 different type of sensor for health monitorings of human patient, number one. Number two, we added one automated guided vehicle mechanisms. It will be automatic. No extra manpower required to move the stretcher. Number two, we fitted one ultrasonic sensor. If suppose during the movement of your stretcher, if suppose somebody is coming in front, so it will stop itself and change the directions. And the lifting mechanism is very simple. Using screw threads, you can lift it, and using one controller, Arduino kit, mobile capture, you can, you know, transport our mobile, bring the mobilization of this innovations. And total cost involved with best feature, best practices, all digitalizations, we can bring this innovation within 50,000 rupees. Now you can compare, you can means it's a brainstorming actually, means how we peoples are, you know, irrespective of department, irrespective of disciplines, we supposed to, you know, should our about all this, you know, all these things. And we need to learn how we can implement best our social practices. Next. We filed a copyright for the same. sustainable solar assisted all natural clay cool refrigeration system. There is a story behind this innovation. There is one person called Mansukh Bhai Prajapati from Gujarat, right? Due to some natural calamity, he developed one innovation, Mitti Cool Refrigeration. It's a modification of Mansukh Bhai Prajapati Mitti Cool Refrigeration system. If you click on your Flipkart or Amazon, you can find pot made up of mitti or soil pots or soil refrigeration system also you can find. What we did exactly, we tried to bring some sustainable approach with this innovation. We fitted one solar panel, one DC inverter, one battery and DC pump. We arranged separate provision for the drinkable water, up to 50 liters you can store. Instead of single wall, left side, right side and back side, we transformed into three different layers or three different walls, you can say. The outer layer we added with aluminium and titanium powder to bring more longevity into cooling effect, to bring more sustainable approach. We added paper pulp, waste cottons and thermocouls. And the inner layer or the third layer is made up of crossed riverside clays. 3 mm venting pipe on the backside of this innovation. And one high speed exhaust fan is fitted on the second rack of this sustainable innovation, solar assisted innovation. When outside air will come inside 3 mm venting pipes, it will absorb moisture and will bring cooling effect not less than 7 to 10 degrees centigrade. Earlier, this innovation was restricted temperature range in between 15 to 17 degrees. But now this innovation available in my department even, I engaged my second year mechanical and second year civil department student because it's a transformation of mechanical and civil engineering practices and some science student also, BSc student together. Without decays of your foods, drinkable item, you can store your eatable food and drinks for 3 days without any decays. We filed one utility patents under intellectual property right government of India. I filed a design patent and granted it. I filed one in the Indian resource copyright, filed it. And I motivated my student to participate one international conference to publish it. Nowadays we are putting effort best for this sustainable practice, how we can come with a, utility. We already developed, you can see in the next slide. Copyright grant, next. This schematic diagram, next. Yes, we participated in XUB Xavier South Asia project competition and we received best prototype award for this innovation. Here you can find my student on the left side and the right side. Next. Next. Wind powered IoT based cost effective sustainable organic compost machine. Now we guys are very habituated to chemical composting, chemical fertilizers, right? We developed the approach that is called your windmill powered or solar assisted sustainable type of composting machine. Compost machine generally available in between 2 to 3 lakh rupees. We installed one compost machines. So whatever waste foods we are getting from canteens, right? Wow, it will take 7 to 15 days time maximum. We are preparing golas of compost and we are using to develop, greenies of our campuses. And we are selling outside also. More than 2000 students are staying here. And we are getting more than 15 buckets of waste food, right? Rice, dal, sabji. We are keeping in racks. We sprinkle water. Then putting inside a compost machine. Then it will churn it, grind it, and compress it into different, this size of balls, right? And we are utilizing that compost to develop the greenies of your garden, and we are selling outside. It's a electrification methods. Without electricity, you can't run the machine. With the same contest, we can generate electricity through windmills and solar panels. Here you can find one DC generator, sorry, one DC motor, one for storing of power, there is a battery, DC motor is fitted, one cabinet is there, fitted with one storing device, right? The central arm of the storing device aligned with the main shaft of the DC motor, right? 50% of energy we're utilizing to rotate the storing blade, and 50% of energy I'm using. This is the theorem. This is the theorem. 50% of energy, whatever I'll generate from the solar panel or windmills, I will utilize to heat up the cabin itself, so that we can prepare ready compost within 7 to 8 days. Next. I filed the copyright. Next. Here you can find on the right diagram. Yes. More than 78% of your waste, only biodegradable type. This innovation made for only equal decaying or equal biodegradable rate of, you know, waste materials or waste products, you can say. If you can utilize this 78%, only happening in metro city 50%. If you can utilize this 78% of your biodegradable waste into fertilizer or composts, we can replace not less than 10% of chemical fertilizer where you are supplying here in India. Next. You can find this one is your organic compost, solar assisted one. Here we can engage our education student and social science student. There is no miracle. Things are available, only we need to brainstorm properly. How we can integrate the things together. Manuals already available with all sets of softwares. Only need to integrate, and we have to motivate our young budding minds to generate or develop such kind of innovation or social practices. Next. Today I supplied a few list of, you know, innovation to our principal, sir. All are medical innovation. Science student and education department student also, you know, they can participate and they can develop these indigenous innovations. If you want, means I will supply all the literature and research review literature review papers. We can motivate our faculty and students to develop this innovation. One of my finest innovation is breath box. You can read the abstract I shared with the PPT. It's a compact rocked ventilator with all sort of digital display using considering the P pressure, Peltau pressure, and oxygen inlet, oxygen outlet of patient monitoring and health condition through one digital display. Next. Python-based database management system for restaurants. Next. Actually, I'm running a lot of time. Next. Next. Is the design of the breath box. It's a box fitted ventilator, and we can manufacture this innovation within 25,000. Within 25,000, we can manufacture this indigenous innovation, and it will be more handy for doctors for any kind of emergency visit also, with 5 liter oxygen capacity, one mainstream type of your pressing device, pressing mechanisms to push the ambu bag. And one control unit is there, one digital display also there. Next. We granted one Indian research copyright for the same. See, yes, let me tell you, only patent and copyrights are, you know, not two features of intellectual property right. For any innovation, you can file for innovation patent, you can file for utility patent, you may go for, if it is a product-based innovation, you can go for industrial, Indian industrial design patents, you can go for Indian resource copyrights, you can go for a trademarks, or you can go for a, what is that called, localized-based innovation chapters. All are putting equal best, it means potential equal best. There is 50 credit out of 420 APIs, 50 credit only stuck for the innovation and publication researching parts. When you will apply for any government or private job opportunity, you can see the performa. 20 APIs we generally assign for your utility patent or innovation. For copyrights, 10. If you are participating in any national level conference or international, it will credit as 1 or 2 API. Your SCI and Scopus Index Journal or Web of Science, it's in between 4 to 6 API. Patent itself, 20 API for your academic credentials. Next. IIC, Government of India, they're encouraging students to participate to learn innovation for POC submission, ideation submissions, prototype developments. It will be amaze you that Government of India having 42 MSMEs all across India, 42 MSMEs. Earlier, I was not a bit aware about it, but now I found for individual innovation, government funding up to 15 lakh rupees. If I'm correct exactly, Government of India sponsoring or providing 50 lakhs rupees for individual innovations. Every quarter, government sponsoring 10 people for one MSME. Now we can calculate how much government investing to promote innovation, incubation, startups, product development, to make student learn for new disruptive technologies. If you calculate very properly, the amount will be 10 into 15 lakh into 4. Every quarter government sponsoring 15 lakh rupees to individual for 10 people. So it will be equal to 15 lakh into 10. Government, we are having 42 MSMEs. That will multiply by 42. We are having 4 quarters. It will multiply by 4. That means it is equal to 15 lakh into 10 into 42 into 4 lakhs. 4. That crore rupees government every year investing for incubation house MSMEs. A best part of MSMEs, they are providing incubation chambers nowadays for faculty and students. Here in CTTC Bhubaneswar, I'm frequently visiting there for different type of, because they are rich in technologies, having heavy machineries, all sort of new machines, and for examination they are having an incubation house. So here you can find a very pleasant atmosphere for student and faculties. Every three semester, every quarter, they are conducting interview, they are inviting student and faculties. Very beautiful. They're sponsoring, they're providing them, you can find nearby your MSMEs. You may send your student and faculties at least to visit and see the practices, how they are promoting peoples for, new product development and innovations. Next. IoT-based sustainable manufacturing of organic fertilizer. It's the best I can say. I'm a bit satisfied with this innovation. I granted it, right? If you rightly observe that your cultivation or farming is the biggest human industry here in India. More than 60% of your total civilization completely depends on farming or cultivation. As a, educational society or intellect society, our prime objective, how we can help our farming through different technology integrations. Here I integrated IoT, Internet of Things. What I did exactly, I have taken 30% by weight of your cow dung and urine, which is cost-effective approach. wastewater taken 30% by waste collected from domestics, 40% by weight of your green leaves. I brought all together, all ingredients, all are costly, free of cost. I brought all the things together into temporary storage devices. With the time enable sluice gate, with respect to time, I allow all the ingredients together to a central mixing chamber. There is a storing unit fitted with a DC motor. To understand the percentage of nitrogen, potassium, and calcium, three sensors I fitted with it. Total system is sustainable using one solar panel. After ready preparation of your organic fertilizer, using a pulsative pump, it will supply to the cultivated land. You can see in the diagram. One farmer sitting at his home, he can operate all the process together using a mobile capture, mobile phone also. For this innovation, I filed one patent for Prestige Institute of Engineering and Management Studies. I granted it. I filed one Indian Resource Copyright. I granted it. Next. Next. He's Mr. Manish. I interacted him last to last month. Now, Government of India and through AICT, they are motivating students, irrespective of all department disciplines, to learn industry demand courses. Our objective, suppose being an engineering college and university, our objective of a student, how will well prepare our student for industry based. And best practices now running with industry is called automations. Now the time of your, what is that called, your sensors, if I'm right properly, CGC, one, let me think about it. That is called your okay, anyway, I've forgotten that. Now, what exactly we are doing in industry? We are integrating sensor communications. I visited one company in Faridabad, Sector 32, for one industrial visit. I found in a shop floor, only 4 persons are there. And it was a assembly unit, automobile assembly unit. Everything was operated, operating using, you know, industrial robots. Right? So industry 4.0, right? We are now talking about. But exactly if you think about the future generation, it will producing threats. Now we are limited, our theorems, our technical inclusions, our fundamentals, our practices, our news, our medias, everybody now limited to industry 4.0. If I'm 100% correct with my statement, nobody, think about the future generations. Industry 4.0 producing a harm for the human labors. If everything will be automatic, right? Then who will work on the ground, means where people will work. So the postulate idea of Industry 5.0, where equal trade potential of machine and human labor will be there. Now every chance and opportunity taken care by machine, because machine can work for 24/7 without any hesitation, without any tiredness, with better productivity, with better feasibility, with accurate product. But if machine will, it's a postulated idea. I'm not standing with my sentences very properly, but if machine will do everything, what about our labor society? What they will do? That's come with a flexible manufacturing units. We're using technologies, our intellect base, we can engage our labor class for better NWOs of required productivity and scientific profits. That is called Industry 5.0, equal trade potential of man and machines. So we have to make our student best practitioner for new technologies, innovation, technologies and practices of industrial practices. So we're supposed to make them learn. First, we learn. Being a faculty, being a mentor, it's our duty to learn first and motivate our generation, new generation, upcoming generations to aware about the upcoming practices and how they can, you know, click for the right tracks. Next. We filed one copyright for blockchain analysis for Industry 4.0. Next. That is called carbonless cooking gasifier. Here in India, more than 6 lakh women dying due to bronchitis during the cooking process due to release of high rate of your carbons, right? This is a statement received from one literature review. We from Jim designed and fabricated one innovation and participated in one international project competition, received the second award for the same. You can see two cylinders, one conical cylinder and one regular cylinder. Equal type of non-biodegradable waste I put it inside into the conical cylinder and fire it with less percentage of oxygen. Whatever unborn gases I receive, I filter using three different layer of carbon filters. After filtration using one, you know, executors, I'll bring the unbound gas to a burner and I fire it. It will be carbonless. So using this concept, we kept this innovation name carbonless cooking gasifiers. Next. It's a design patent we received for the same. It's a grant for us. You can read the challenges or, you know, problems, objections. Before filing patent, two different we were filing patent, online and offline. When we're filing online, we're supposed to take care of signatories and submission of required 2 number of copies to the IP India. When it is offline, with proper signatory of inventor and applicants, right? We need to submit it. Next. It's a grant for us. I'm running short of time. So many work hazards are there. I'm not able to concentrate on Indian patents. Next. Next. The design for the same. Next. Next. Is the flow chart of your industrial waste candle catris we manufactured. Next. A novel domestic waste treatment plan using different layer of sustainable layering system, different ranges of grains and gravel and sustainable organic layers. We filtrate the wastewater coming from domestic for plantations for gardening. Next. Sustainable digital farming robot. I was the faculty of Lingayat University. With my IB Tech student, we developed this robot. As people are much more dependent on farming, it's the real time and engage our student, motivate our youngster to learn how smart integration can be a part of farming units for better yield and productivity. Smart control, smart sensing, smart monitoring, cloud-based operating system, smart plantations, smart cultivations. In fact, I am with PIMR College, Indore, Prestige Institute. Now I'm coming with 5 more innovation. One robotic plugging hand for cultivation purpose, right? It will be helpful to cultivate or to harvest all underground vegetables like your potato, onion, garlic, underground things. No? So automatic robotic hand will harvest the things with automatic water irrigation system. I'm using 3 LoRa device ranging up to 12 kilometers. Means within 12 kilometer radius, you can operate the things. You can understand soil conditioning, soil monitoring systems, atmospheric conditioning system, automatic visualization systems, right? Means sitting at a house, you can visualize your farm conditioning. you can understand whether irrigation is required or not, using different type sensors. Now technology is so improved. Your electronics and telecommunication is so coming with so advanced form for all kind of operation sensors are available. No rocket science is there. Only you need to understand the problem. We need to learn one software for, you know, maybe Python or embedded something. Earlier it was embedded one. Earlier it was PCB based. Now everything is PLC based. So with respect to transformation of education technology, we need to our student, a young generation, to learn it and to implement. These are the things when student will, you know, get motivated to learn the digitalized practices. Now everything is digitalized. Earlier watches, these are the old traditional watch. Digital came, then sensor integration came, then you can speak over, you know, your watches, you can see your friends, right? So every time you can find, even if in medical science, education, social science, engineering, every day we need to update our. We're not supposed to run with, you know, ancient practices. When we learn means we can motivate. If you won't learn means how will motivate? Student will stop respecting us. So first of all, we need to learn. Next. Actually, I'm running short of time. I need to go outside. So next, it's a lengthy 1.5 years. We developed this innovation with my faculties, lab assistant, students together, one disinfectant sanitizer tunnel at cost of 9,000 only. Same product available in IndiaMart, not less than 35,000 rupees. Only we integrated sensor, control unit, Arduino, Python-based programs, mobile operation, everything available in internet. Only thing is we need to learn and how to practice the thing with the real applications. Next. 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 If any question, please, you may raise the question. This is the distance measuring device. In COVID, what now? We need to maintain social distancing. Say it's 1 meter or 2 meter. If you're not attending the same, one camera vision system is there. Machine learning is that much prompt. It can understand the temperature. Even if in health education, hospitals, you can find robots are utilizing for transportation of patients, for transportation of surgical instruments. So it's a innovation made by Enthu Technology Hyderabad. They developed this indigenous innovation to understand the social distancing at cost of 6,000 rupees. When we are coming with a new innovation, we are supposed to practice how come our product or practices come with less price compared to existing prices, existing market price. Then only it will be regarded as a successful innovation. It's supposed to be handy, reliable, customer user friendly. And before making any innovation, we supposed to find the target audience for whom you are making the things, for whom you are, you know, practicing the things and bringing this innovations. Next. Any questions? Health ATM, you can find this innovation at Lucknow Railway Station. I walked all around India. With my 14-year experience, I moved all around India. I visited different university practices, wherever I will find some new stops. I try to, you know, engage with my speech. Next. Next. The ventilator approaches we designed and define different type of concepts into different pressing mechanisms of bamboo bag ventilator. We designed 4 different type of linear type of ventilator mechanisms and filed Indian patents for the same. Next. These are the different designs using Catia V6. This is the Ashok Leyland product. Earlier, this ventilator was available with 2 lakhs to 3 lakh rupees. Now, technology changed. ICMR accreditations also changed. Now, products are available easily, cost-effective approach. Next. Aushadh Vastra, it's a herbal, mask manufactured and patented by one of my friends from Andhra Pradesh. These are the different mechanisms we formulated from kinematic of machines, whatever teaching to our second year, third year student. Next, it's a sanitizer, door-based disinfectant sanitizer at low cost, 4,000 rupees using one humanoid sensor and controlling unit. E-Vidyalaya is a portal for better understanding, better learning practices for student and faculty together. Or online attendance system, online blackboard, online note sharing basis. We design and develop this mobile app. Now few students, they are using this innovation. Next. Next. Technology development. Come to the last slide, please. Last. Yes. IIT, they are promoting student from different universities and institutions for this, Navbharat Abhiyan. They are promoting and they are sponsoring 5 lakh rupees. Means under your institute, we can take care of 5 villages. And we'll our people about new technologies, social impactful, sustainable approaches. They're releasing the amount step by step. First, they will release 50,000, then 2 lakh rupees, then 2.5 lakh rupees. You can form a team through proper application and drafts. We need to submit to the nearby IIT. Right? If it is best practice ever through examinations, they will fund you for up to 5 lakh rupees for any kind of rural or urban or semi-urban based technological practices or innovation or incubation startups. Right? Next. Technology Development Board, Government of India also promoting COVID-based innovation. So if you're having any kind of sustainable practices or cost-effective approaches into different type of sanitizer or disinfectant sanitizer tunnel, globe, mask, wearings, transportation system that will be helpful, remote monitoring system, healthcare units, right? You can apply and you can direct consult to the coordinators. They're very free to communicate with the institutes. Student also can draft their files. Right, for funding opportunities. So we need to motivate our faculties and students together for such kind of things.
The participants are requested to ask any question from the resource person. You can write in the chat box or you can raise your hand. We will give an audio control to the participants. You can unmute yourself to ask any question related to the session regarding innovations and IPR. Sir, can I ask one question?
Yes, sir. Yes.
What is the role of interdisciplinary studies in conducting any innovation, sir?
You can find one book, Interdisciplinary Bridging Gap Between Education and Industry Requirements. I'm running with volume 7, sir.
Okay.
From my early talk, I narrated that innovation always interdisciplinary. I'm telling you why. If suppose you talk about a electric vehicle, right? Number one, what's its social aspects? We have to formulate it first. What sort of technology? If you talk about engineering practices, mechanical is there, electrical is there, electronics there, computer science also there, right? So before defining any innovation, first of all, we have to search the marketing strategy, number one. Number two, how different way it will be helpful to the society. It's multidisciplinary. Management can comes into play into forming and incubation development period and time frame and cost involvement. Broadly, if you talk about innovation, irrespective of all department, even if law department, every innovation having their own inclusions with some sort of, you know, government agendas, government guidelines that is coming under laws even. You need to define it very properly when you are filing a patent. Patent is not all about, you know, new things or any rocket science something. Patent is all about how this innovation can helpful for the society. Now, our perspective supposed to be very clear. What's supposed to be objective and in which ways it is come with, you know, better, bright outcomes, right? It'll be helpful for the society, number one. Right marketing strategy. How innovative ways we can reach our target audience. Obviously, it is societal one. So, irrespective of department. Engineering, technology, science concern. It's a part of. So, patent is irrespective of department, interdisciplinary way. We can consider everybody and anybody can participate and be part of innovations.
Thank you, sir. Sir, as most of the staff members will be from the arts faculty, commerce faculty, so what are the different platforms where they can find a good theoretical framework regarding the innovations and IPRs? Because you have beautifully explained the practical examples and it's very nice to see so much work done by you and your team. So I think we all are new in this field. We may need some theoretical basis also before going to the practical side. So kindly share some.
Nowadays, I'm coming with 7 more innovations into medical newborns, pediatrics department, and some technology integration, deep learnings. So in this aspect, if you consider, faculties can, your art science faculties and commerce background faculty, they can integrate with, you know, commercial aspect of this innovation, marketing aspect of this innovation, social aspect of innovation, right? Patenting also one heavy, you know, monetary engagement process nowadays. I'm telling you, if you are finding a best attorney, they'll charge not less than 30,000-40,000 rupees. Government registration itself, 10,000 rupees, 12,000 rupees. And if you are applying for the Tatkal patents, 19,100 rupees. So lump sum, it's a complete investment of 60,000 or 65,000. If you are really, filing a patent in proper procedures, right? So it's not a, means engagement of one person. So with the team, professor teams, generally I'm motivating, guiding faculties, a student together to file a patent. So anybody can be part, sir. But not only like this, means they will put their name and designation to be part of this innovation. We'll assign them to do some work with respect to target audience finding or introductory or formation of abstract. Not only to theoretically, if it is possible, we'll engage them into practical approach and incubation development of these innovations. Everybody can be part, sir. Everybody can.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Parikh, can I ask a question?
Yes, please. Sir.
Okay, sir. In continuation to Dr. Parikh's first question only, like you said, anything we can patent, like for example, in our teacher education, we are all from that background and where like I understand patenting basically what theoretically it is related to some inventions or something. So like if we are making some teaching strategy or yes. Can that be patented or something? Like we do understand we make tools for research. For that copyrights are reserved. So copyright part of IPR, we understand, we are using it. Book hum publish karte, usme humare copyrights reserve ho jate, copyright permission le lete hai. So hum patenting, where can we use that in our field of teacher education, in school education, in college education, teacher education?
Any kind of portal you may develop, ma'am, learning portal or learning app you can develop, any surfing website you can develop, downloadable website you can develop, any product based thing means you can go for the patent.
Okay,
any theoretical based means yes, any theoretical concept means you can go for the Indian resource copyright matter.
No, for copyright, but then that cannot be patented, that can be copyright.
Yes, only theoretical means it's copyright, ma'am.
Copyright. Patenting, it has to be an invention.
Yeah, invention or transformation of a existing product with better feasibility and prospective studies.
Right, for patenting, we need a product.
Yes.
Which else, what other IPR practice can we use in our teacher education besides copyrights? What else can we use?
I'm telling you, na, you can develop a product. Product may be a software, may be a portal, may be a mobile app. Education department, so far with my knowledge base, is limited to these areas for filing of the patent.
Okay.
Europe, we can take the copyright or trademarks.
Or trademarks. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank
geographical you. Indications. With respect to any particularized innovation practices, you can ask for the geographical indication, madam.
Right.
But all are producing equal potential under intellectual property, right, Government of India. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Any other question from any participant? And we will also like to share with you all that the feedback link is already shared in the chat box and it will not be shared anywhere else. So those participants who have attended the session can fill the feedback link right now in the chat box. And you are most welcome for any question to the resource person. You can write in chat box or you can raise your hand. I think if no question, Dr. Ramandeep, you can proceed further, please.
Yes, can we proceed, sir?
Yes, yes, please. I think no question.
Okay.
One question is there. Where we can make recognition of unique innovation and how much time it would take? See, the uniqueness of innovation you can receive from your novelty, right? From Google patent, you can receive your novelty or newness of your innovations. And innovation not taking time. Sometime it will take reach of 5 years time to develop one innovation. Sometime in simple brainstorming, one big idea can, you know, reflect, means it will reflect for innovation practices. I'm telling you, the innovation I have started with your electrical vehicle, with our faculty and lab assistant, we brainstormed for 3 days, complete 3 days working hours. We formulated the design, we derived it for the required torque and rotations, and we validated the things. I will share the photographs with the principal, sir, with all sort of, you know, assumptions and all sort of experimental validations, so that you can understand. Sometimes it will take fraction of seconds. Sometimes it will take, long time for the to bring the scientific validations of your theorems. So it depends.
Thank you very much, sir. I think there is no more questions. So we move further. We are inviting Dr. Seema Kapoor, Member, Research and Development Cell, Shri Atam Ballabh Jain College, Ludhiana, one of our mentee college, for formally presenting vote of thanks. Dr. Seema?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good evening to all. A graceful and warm evening to our most valued and distinguished guests, management committee members, worthy teachers, and my dear friends. It is my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion I, Dr. Seema Kapoor, on behalf of GHD Khalsa College of Education, Gurusar Sadar, Shri Atam Vallabh Dhyan College, Ludhiana, Arya College, Ludhiana, Cordia College, Sangul, Innocent Hearts College, Jalandhar, and Baba Bhag Singh Memorial College, Moga. First of all, extend my most sincere thanks to the resource person, Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda, Dean Research and Development Cell, Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology, who spared time from his busy schedule to grace the occasion. I thank him for sharing his valuable information with us. With his style and own idea of explanation about innovation and IPR practices, I mention my deepest sense of appreciation and would place on record my hearty thanks to make this event meaningful and interesting. Sir, your innovations on indigenous thermal mattresses to prevent neonatal hypothermia, cost-effective water filtration using industrial fly ash waste, sustainable manufacturing process of eco-friendly, 3D printing filament, digital iron removal, guided self-sustaining hybrid e-vehicles, Arogya Odisha, sustainable digital farming robot, e-Vidyalaya, and many more will definitely benefit the society. I also extend my thanks to all the teachers for their cooperation. Events like this cannot happen overnight. So I specifically thank the people who have been the backbone of the event. I would like to give my vote of thanking to the entire team of GHD Khalsa College of Education. Thank you so much for your cooperation. And lastly, and not the least, thanks to all the people who are listening patiently and they have made this event successful. Thank you to all. Have a wonderful evening ahead. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. And thank you, Dr. Ramesh, on behalf of the mentor and the mentee colleges. Again, heartfelt thanks to the resource person for his deliberations. Thank you, sir, for such an exhaustive experiences that you've shared. Dr. Parkit, can we end the session here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Thank you
all. All the participants have filled the feedback for link, which is shared in Zoom chat. Please check the Zoom chat and fill the feedback link. Your certificate will be generated through this feedback link, and please wait for some time for your certificates.
Bargat sir, do you think we should keep the meeting on for 2-3 minutes so that those who are left can fill the feedback link?
Yes, we can. We can open the meeting for just 2 minutes more.
Okay, that suits better, because in case anybody's left, can do it. Can all the participants also put up their camera so that we can also have a picture? Parvet sir, please click the picture. That will be a better option.
Okay, ma'am.
You will be able to do it better.
Okay, no issue. I will do it. Just a minute, I'm doing this. It's done, ma'am. So we will also share some of the examples of innovation where you all can work in your chat in the WhatsApp group. Sir has given some topics which we can explore at our end for starting a new work. I will share those topics in the WhatsApp group also. Thanks to all for attending today's webinar.
A mediocre teacher explains. A good teacher demonstrates, and a great teacher inspires. A journey which began over 100 years ago, this is the story of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Khalsa College, also known as the Wonder in Rural Hinterland.